street. I didn't know what it was at first.
Well, you know? What makes you think it's a fire bomb?
Because it was an explosion.
And while the crime lab still has some testing to do, Eden, the city's newest accelerant detecting canine, a 20-month-old black lab, hit on something in the debris to indicate it was a firebomb.
Oh, it is arson. It's incendiary, intentional in nature. The fire started at 6724, extended down the porch roots to 6710 and north to 6730.
Now, there was no one home at the targeted home, no word on a motive for the firebombing, and fortunately, the neighbors in all of these homes were able to get out safely. Live in Tacony, I'm Mike Strug, NBC 10 News.
Tonight, a bizarre accident in South Jersey takes the life of a beloved doctor.
Dr. Michelle Battistini helped hundreds of patients. This morning, she was driving to work when something flew off the road, smashed through her windshield, and killed her.
NBC 10's Don Lemon is live at the University of Pennsylvania Hospital where she worked with that story. Don.
Yeah, Larry and Tracy, Dr. Michelle Battistini was an international expert on menopause. And tonight we spoke with her friend and colleague who worked with her on that issue. And we also spoke with her best friend.
When Dr. Michael Sirigliano goes into work from now on, it'll be without his fellow doctor, friend, and confidant, Dr. Michelle Battistini.
I'm going to miss the collegial interaction with her, and I'm going to miss her giving me a hug when I need it and me giving her a hug when she needed it.
44-year-old Dr. Michelle Battistini lost her life on her way to work on I-76 near Route 130 in Gloucester City, New Jersey. Police say an unknown object covered with tar flew through her windshield, hitting her in the forehead. Her car spun out of control.
My colleagues came to me and told me the news. I didn't believe it. I just couldn't believe it. It was just beyond belief.
No one ever expects such a thing, especially of someone who devoted her life to helping other people. An international expert on menopause, a highly acclaimed physician featured in Philadelphia Magazine as one of the top doctors for women. She also pioneered a successful comprehensive health program called Penn Health for Women.
And not just women's issues, but patient issues. She was an advocate for her patients. She was loved by her patients.
She was carrying her son when she delivered my daughter, and I can't tell you how special it was to have her there.
Michelle Battistini's friends now remember her not only for her work, but as a wife and a devoted mother of two teenage children.
There's one more angel in heaven today.
Now, just a short time ago, I spoke with Dr. Battistini's daughter. She says they will begin to make funeral arrangements tomorrow, and she said those services should be sometime over the weekend. Live in University City, I'm Don Lemon, NBC 10 News.
Now the latest on today's deadly crash of a small plane in Berks County. This was the scene from Chopper 10 shortly after the accident. The plane had just taken off from Reading Regional Airport. It went down in a neighbor's backyard about a mile away. The pilot, 53-year-old Dennis Gould of New York, was killed instantly. He was the only person on board the plane. Tonight, the Federal Aviation Administration has ruled the crash an accident. The plane crashed near Upper Van Reed Road at Reber's Bridge Road in Bern Township, Berks County. Again, this was the scene on the ground, NBC 10 in Bern Township, where the impact shook Joan Hoster's house. The burning wreckage of the downed plane scorched her garden just yards from where she was standing.
This went like, and then that's it.
That was it.
Big, big explosion. Shook everything. My heart was in my throat.
No one on the ground was hurt. Witnesses at Reading Airport saw white puffs of smoke coming from one of the plane's engines during takeoff.
On the NBC 10 Strike Watch, not much progress tonight in the Ben Salem teachers' strike, I'm sorry to say. No new talks were scheduled between the union and the school district. Negotiations are hung up over salary, benefits, and class size. More than 6,500 students are affected by the strike. Some positive news, however, tonight in the Colonial teachers' strike in Montgomery County. Contract talks are back on. The district and teachers' union will be back at the bargaining table on Friday. The sticking points here, money and health care. It's school as usual in the Council Rock District in Bucks County, but support staff there are threatening to strike. A new round of contract talks began late today. No word on any movement. Support staff includes nurses, teacher aides, secretaries, and custodial workers. Hotlines have been set up for the latest on the Ben Salem strike. Call 215-750-2800. And you can get updates on the Colonial strike by calling 610-834-1671. Tomorrow, some 214,000 students go back to school in Philadelphia, but the funding crisis between the city and state continues tonight. Mayor John Street vetoed a bill that would have used $45 million in city money for the Philadelphia School District. He did that just tonight. The money was supposed to be a one-time payment to help close the budget deficit. In exchange, Governor Ridge would have given $60 million of state money to Philadelphia schools. Tonight, Mayor Street says he killed the deal because he was afraid the city would have to kick in additional funding for years to come.
Tonight, a story you'll see only on NBC10. One of our viewers got quite a surprise when she checked out a religious website. The site ends up showing her the Pope and pornography. What's worse, she can't get rid of it. NBC10's Doug Scheimel has the details.
When I clicked on that link, I was disgusted and just really surprised by what happened.
What happened to Bridget Hylak could happen to you or your kids on the internet. The web designer was looking for a Spanish language version of the Catholic Catechism and thought she had found a link to one.
And I was instead taken into an unexitable maze of pornographic sites.
And that Catholic communicator link she clicked on wouldn't go away. When Bridget tried to close the window, another graphic porn ad would appear, then another, each one more sexually explicit. She thought she finally escaped, only to find the porn ads had followed her and started reappearing. Bridget finally had no choice but to shut down her web browser.
Someone apparently deliberately had coded, miscoded this link into what is otherwise, as far as I can see, a very legitimate Catholic site with a lot of good information.
But how did an obscure Catholic research link suddenly become a porn site? Well, NBC 10 has learned that certain internet pornography companies are deliberately buying up expired domain names on Catholic websites as some kind of revenge or shock marketing campaign, and the unsuspecting user won't know until it's too late. We contacted the upstate New York web company that hosts the site and were told, quote, we did not know that domain name had been bought. The first thing we did was to check the link and immediately remove it. Doug Scheimel, NBC 10 News.
Now we got this story from a viewer email tip. If you have news, let us know by coming to our website at NBC10.com and click on the link that says submit your story.
Tonight, a nun who was attacked by a vicious pit bull is speaking out about her ordeal.
I felt a pressure on the back of my head, and I said, they're biting me on the head.
Even worse, she lost her beloved dog, Lindy, in that attack. Her story is just ahead.
Plus, bike thefts are on the rise in our area, and if you think it's just a petty crime, wait until you hear what one of the victims has to say. That story's coming up. I'm CNBC's Maria Bartiromo. Coming up next, where did Wall Street close out the day? Plus, what to look for tomorrow. That's next on NBC 10 News.
I'm John Belaris. What a beautiful day today. Will it last through tomorrow into Friday? What about your weekend? You'll find out in just a few minutes when we come right back.
And as John often tells you, you can get the exclusive Earthwatch forecast anytime on our website. Go to NBC10.com and click on Earthwatch. We'll be back in a moment.
Save up to 80% buying Factory Direct. The jewelry factory makes most of their jewelry in their state-of-the-art factory, imports their diamonds direct, and guarantees the lowest price. Compare Tiffany's 1-carat platinum band for $5,800 with the jewelry factory's for $1,500. 1-carat hearts are $199, 2-carat bracelets $349, 1-carat studs $399. The jewelry factory has a huge selection and guarantees all the jewelry they make to appraise for at least double. Buy Factory Direct, the jewelry factory in Norristown.
Help, I've fallen and I can't get up.
The sad truth is that one out of every three seniors will have a serious fall this year. If you or a loved one are at risk, please consider the following. In a home emergency, even if there is a phone in every room of your house, your chances of being within reach of that phone are very unlikely. You could remain helpless, on the floor, cut off from the outside world. Don't risk lying on the floor for hours or even days. These one-time emergencies can easily turn into permanent disabilities. Why risk ending up in a costly nursing facility, losing your home and independence? Life Alert can help you avert a catastrophe with this simple pendant. Push it anywhere in your home or yard in 24 hours a day, the Life Alert Security Center will summon the help you need, fast.
Call 1-800-909-8820 to receive free information about Life Alert's round-the-clock 24-hour protection. The phone call and the information are free. Don't delay. Call this toll-free number now.
Home much time does it take to make someone smile? How much time do you need to really touch a good friend? When you get down to it, some of the most important things happen in a moment. This is the thought behind Our Daily Bread, a collection of devotional stories you can spend just minutes a day with. Yet with the power to touch you forever with the Word of God. And you can receive Our Daily Bread at no cost or obligation. Just call 1-888-243-9282 now, and we'll deliver Our Daily Bread right to your home. You'll see why millions of readers have turned to Our Daily Bread's inspiring, life-changing stories for their moments of quiet reflection. Because the most important things don't have to take much time at all. Call 1-888-243-9282 now for Our Daily Bread.
Now a story you saw first on NBC10, a Philadelphia nun attacked by two pit bulls talks about her harrowing ordeal tonight. Sister Barbara Kohler was attacked last month while walking her dog near her convent in Olney. She says two pit bulls jumped on her without any warning. Sister Barbara was bitten several times and needed to go to the hospital. But the worst part, she says, was losing her dog, Lindy.
And I'm trying to protect Lindy, and she was grabbed by the two dogs. One had her by the neck, one had her by the back of the leg, and they were playing tug of war with her.
So I guess he was offended.
James Maracci owns the pit bulls. He says Sister Barbara hit one of his dogs with a stick, provoking that attack. Sister Barbara says that's just not true. One of the dogs is now home with Maracci. The other dog is still being observed by the SPCA.
Bike riders beware. Thieves are targeting bicycles in Center City, Philadelphia. Police say 57 bikes have been stolen from Center City streets in the past 2 months. That's double what they normally see. Dozens of the bikes were left unlocked and unattended, but some were stolen right from their owners' hands.
I was coming out of CVS and two guys came behind me, put a gun up to my head, told me to get off my damn bike. So I had no choice but to go ahead and jump off the bike and give it to them.
To help foil thieves, make sure you lock your bike with a substantial lock. Remove the seat and take it with you. Police also suggest removing the front wheel and locking it to the frame. Police have arrested seven suspects for bike theft. They have put plainclothes police officers on the street in an effort to collar more. Larry?
The Philadelphia Zoo has stepped up efforts to protect animals after one of them has died from West Nile virus. A pink flamingo that was with the zoo for more than 20 years was infected with the virus and died. West Nile virus has spread through mosquitoes. With that in mind, zoo officials are taking new precautions. The flamingos will be kept inside in the morning and evening when mosquitoes feed. Officials at the zoo say your risk of catching West Nile here is no greater than catching it in your own backyard. You can see exactly where West Nile virus has turned up near you. Come to our website at NBC10.com, then click on news links. You will find connections to the West Nile.
All factories, and New England's big.